And we're back for part three of a Let's Pray. Oh boy. 3, 2, 1. As I mentioned earlier, I'm going to try and stay quiet. You have different sections of track. You have different areas of the track that comprise each and every lap. Now, the first two laps have no real differences between each other. It's lap three that's weird, because lap three actually does slightly change the track. So you see that countdown timer? Yeah, you have to make it to the next segment of the track before that timer's done. So you fail otherwise, which means don't get hit, which seems a lot easier, which is a lot easier said than done. That was one hit. There's three. I just forked the dog. Hi, pupper, I just forked you. I didn't fork anything. I'm actually... just died in the same spot. Alrighty. So, real best strategy, Al, is to get all of these speakers if possible, and to Al. Yeah, so remember the last episode when I said it was going to be a solid 20 minutes of me failing at this level? Here's why. Now, while the speed boosts are helpful, it is often the best route to just try and avoid getting hit, wherever possible. And then use the speed boosts after the whole Tuscan Raider section. Which they do retain their canonical names from the Pope. Some bullshit. So are gonna wanna remain out. If I make it in time, I will be very pleased. I'm just trying to see what will work. This section seems easy until you realize, what are those little black things? Oh, bombs? Right, that's normal. However, I advanced to lap two, where there may be a slight change in one of the segments, or all of them, I can't quite remember. I do know that the major changes occur. Never mind, I was completely wrong. Major change occurs lap two. Famous scene where Sebulba knocks that bitch off the race whack, and he blows up and knocks over an entire rock pillar. Have fun with this one. I guess you can in fact obtain a piece of mini kit up there, and that's really the only reason that there's a detour there. It serves no better purpose. And out onto here. Oh shit, boulders! Boulders are gonna fuck your day up. Why are they gonna fuck your day up? Because the Tuscan Raiders say- Oh no! Oh no, I've taken on so much damage from the last section. What? Oh my god. Okay. Either that or... Oh boy. You also die with the crashing boulders. It's a really fair and fun level, everybody. Yeah, the reason I moved the mic off of me is because A, Rumble is on all the fucking time in this level, and B, yeah. I'm not doing this level stationary because there is no real incentive to. Moving is the only way I'm gonna get this level done. Because if I need a split second jump back, and one, oh, you bastards! That is the cheap part about this level that they modified ever so slightly in Complete Saga. They made it a lot less of a penalty to be, like, there's, I don't really remember if there's a time penalty or not. I actually haven't played Complete Saga in a while. There might be bonus content after we defeat the first two games, detailing the differences. Most of the levels stayed completely intact, with the only real difference, of course, being pod racing and the one level for episode two, and some minor changes and additions, to the game. I am better with, I believe, the release of the time, which was like a yep, I screwed the pooch on this one. So like I said, we're 6 minutes in and I'm only on lap two. Now thankfully there's no game over screen that takes you back to the beginning of lap one. That would be cheap. However, this is definitely not a fun level. Now that is a rogue little bullet thing that always happens. It is annoying, it feels unfair, but that's par for the course with this level. There's nothing fair about this level. You kind of have to be up here early. 3-2 oblige. Yeah. So, now we're out here. You might be asking yourselves, can it get any worse? The answer is always yes. There's mines, as there were before, but there is significantly more of them. One! Nice! Heading into lap three. We are doing pretty fine. And... actually, let's... our best piece of it now. Yeah, no, that was bad, but I still have a chance. Oh, shit. I just flew right into a wall. Sometimes that is the issue with this game. Or the level, sorry. The game's fine with textures. Sometimes the issue with this level is you really just can't see what the fuck you're doing. In, like, the cave or something. Oh, right into a pit. Yeah, it is a lengthy level when you haven't, like, played the game in a while, or you're, you know, not really focusing on it deeply. Like, if I really wanted to, I could probably restart right now and if I was being quiet playing for a personal run, it would actually be a lot more expletives and a lot less focus, because I wouldn't be worried about, you know, people seeing my skills. But at the same time, there's just this certain level of calm that comes with... Oh! Right there! If I didn't bump off that other wall, it would be fine. Alright, so... this is definitely one of those things that would have made me put the controller down as a youngling. As a young Padawan, I would not have been able to keep up with this level at a younger age, which is quite astoundingly why I'm so glad I played Complete Saga as a youngling. Might as well use Star Wars terminology. Because it was, you know, really more built for someone who couldn't afford to throw the controller. See, I can't afford to throw my controller. Maybe not the controller I'm holding right now, which is a Spice Orange GameCube controller, which is part of the reason I use it, because I will refuse to throw it, because I'm about to find another one of those. So especially for less than you paid for the forge. Alright, I should be fine. I don't whack off any more walls. And I did whack off walls, but... yeah, so all the boulders are out now, which makes this section even more hard. You really have to follow panels here. And more than you would think. I can do this. Yes, I can. Yeah, so... Oh, ouch. Yeah, I got domed on that one. See, that's what I don't like. I don't understand how a little laser bullet would push a fucking pod racer into a rock. I do understand how bad driving would do it. How did I? Whatever. Ah! That doesn't make sense! That bullet would not push a pod racer! Actually, that bullet would. That bullet literally is the size of the thing, which is weird. I can't afford to get hit anymore because it's a cheap game. I'm just kidding. There's obviously a route around everything. You just have to be good at it. It is a bob and weave route. Which I don't think I've ever used. Nope. I was gonna see if I could pull a hard left. Oh, balls. Yeah, remember when I said 20 minutes of failing? This is another reason why. This section is bad as well. Not as, I would say, bad as the... this is just always the worst, you know, segment of the track. You really have to pay attention, so I'm gonna go silent for a moment. That is not! No! That's bullshit! I totally made it! I don't even think I got hit in this section. Does that make sense? Oh,
How you like me now, bitches?
We won the money. We got the part. We took the boy. Yeah. Part blah. We're gonna end this episode here because, like I said, entire episode where one level was dominant. So, until next time, by next time, I mean in about, 20 seconds, see you later.